Hi, I'm Cheryl Cero, research fellow in Aaron Cypress's lab at the NIH, and I would like to introduce you to our recent paper entitled Beta-3 Adrenergic Receptors Regulate Human Brown Beige Adipocyte Lipolysis and Thermogenesis, recently published in JCI Insight. It is controversial whether the beta-3 adrenergic receptor in humans have a role in regulating adipocyte metabolism, and this is due to its relatively low levels of mRNA when compared to rodent adipose tissue and poor cross-species selectivity of some of the beta-3 receptor agonists. However, clinical evidence showed that activation of the beta-3 receptor with the selective beta-3 receptor agonist mirabegron does increase human brown adipose tissue metabolic activity, whole body energy expenditure, as well as plasma free fatty acids and brown adipose tissue glucose uptake. So given this clinical data, we hypothesize that the beta-3 adrenergic receptor in human brown beige adipocytes may play a role in thermogenesis and lipid metabolism. And as I will show, beta-3 adrenergic receptors in human brown beige adipocytes are required to maintain multiple components of the lipolytic and thermogenic cellular machinery, and that the beta-3 adrenergic receptor agonists could be used to achieve metabolic benefit in humans. In this study, we used differentiated primary adipocytes derived from the supraclavicular region, the region with the highest enrichment of adipocytes expressing the thermogenic protein uncoupling protein 1, or UCP1, as our in vitro model to evaluate the functional roles of the beta-3 adrenergic receptor. We isolated adipocyte progenitors from the supraclavicular region, cultured and differentiated them into mature adipocytes. And as shown by the microscopy images as well as the all-red-o staining, upon induction, the primary pre-adipocytes transitioned from a fibroblast-like morphology to a mature adipocyte phenotype containing multiple lipid droplets. These polyclonal differentiated primary cells were brown-beige adipocytes as they expressed the UCP1 gene and protein. Immunohistochemistry staining with the mitotracker dye relieved an abundance of mitochondria in the differentiated cells expressing UCP1, also providing evidence for co-localization of UCP1 in the mitochondria. Along with UCP1, these adipocytes also exhibited higher levels of many other brown-beige adipocyte markers as well as thermogenic markers, and increased levels of beta-1, beta-2, and beta-3 receptor genes. To determine the role of the beta-3 adrenergic receptor, we next silenced the ADRB3 gene in differentiated adipocytes using lipofectamine-based transfection. Relative to the control, siRNA transfected cells, here represented in white, the siRNA targeting ADRB3, represented in the red bars, reduced ADRB3 by 95%. Reduction of the ADRB3 expression led to a substantial downregulation of genes involved in mitochondrial thermogenesis, including UCP1, which was reduced by 90%. Additionally, genes encoded by mitochondrial DNA, MTCO2 and TFAM, were also reduced, suggesting lower mitochondrial quantity. Co-staining with mitotracker dye and an anti-UCP1 antibody corroborated the gene expression profiling and revealed lower mitochondria and UCP1 protein levels in the siRNA ADRB3 brown beige adipocytes. We next assess the functional implications of the loss of the beta-3 adrenergic receptor in human brown beige adipocytes, and found that silencing ADRB3 in absence of ligand lowered unstimulated cyclic AMP levels, suggesting a reduction in adenylate cyclase activity. Moreover, when we treated the cells either with foscolin or with isoproterenol, the siRNA ADRB3 adipocytes displayed a lower ability to generate cyclic AMP compared to the control cells. Control and silenced ADRB3 cells had similar unstimulated lipolysis. However, the siRNA ADRB3 adipocytes had a 70% reduced capacity to undergo lipolysis upon foscolin treatment, suggesting impairment in the downstream beta-adrenergic signaling. We therefore assessed the expression of key lipolytic proteins, including adipocyte triglyceride lipase, ATGL, hormone-sensitive lipase, and CGI58, which is a direct activator of ATGL. Immunoblotting showed similar levels of actin, perilipin, total HSL, and phosphorylated HSL in the siRNA ADRB3 adipocytes relative to the siRNA control adipocytes at baseline, as well as in response to foscolin treatment. In contrast, independent of foscolin treatment, the siRNA ADRB3 cells had lower levels of ATGL and higher levels of CGI 58 protein levels. This phenotype could explain the reduced intracellular triglyceride lipolysis even after fosgonimeton treatment. Since lipolysis is essential for brown adipose tissue thermogenesis, and knowing that the siRNA ADRB3 adipocytes have a compromised lipolytic phenotype, we investigated cellular respiration in the siRNA control and the ADRB3 primary brown beige adipocytes by subjecting them to a mitochondrial stress test. As shown by the oxygen consumption trace on the top left, the siRNA ADRB3 transfected adipocytes, represented in red, had a lower overall oxygen consumption rate compared to their controls, which are represented in black, with a significant impairment in increasing uncoupled respiration, ATP-linked respiration, and FCCP-induced maximal respiration. To unambiguously examine the requirement of ADRB3 in the lipolytic activity, which is required for UCP1 thermogenic activity since UCP1 is activated by fatty acids released from intracellular lipolysis, we used fosgonimeton to stimulate lipolysis and monitored cellular respiration. We found that the siRNA ADRB3 transfected cells, when treated with fosgonimeton, had lower proton leak and lower maximal respiration. This confirms that functional ADRB3 is required for lipolysis-induced fatty acid activation of UCP1-mediated uncoupled respiration in cultured brown-beige adipocytes. Beta-1 and beta-2 adrenergic receptors have been implicated in human white and brown adipocyte triglyceride hydrolysis, while the involvement of the beta-3 adrenergic receptors remains controversial. So to evaluate whether beta-3 adrenergic receptors participate in the stimulation of lipolysis in human brown-beige adipocytes, we measured lipolysis in response to mirabegron, currently the only FDA-approved agonist selective for the human beta-3 adrenergic receptor. We did a dose-response experiment and found that compared to the unstimulated state in the siRNA control adipocytes, mirabegron induced lipolysis at 100 nanomolar, 1 micromolar, and 10 micromolar. In contrast, in adipocytes with silenced ADRB3, mirabegron-induced lipolysis was increased only at 10 micromolar. To corroborate that a reduction of functional ADRB3 that affects lipolysis also affects respiratory capacity in human brown-beige adipocytes, we monitor cellular bioenergetics in these silenced ADRB3 cells treated with mirabegron. As shown by the OCAR tracing on the bottom left and the quantifications on the right, in response to mirabegron, the siRNA control adipocytes augmented the uncoupled respiration as well as the maximal respiration, where the ADRB3 transfected cells had similar response to their respective vehicle-treated cells. These data indicate that mirabegron, acting via the beta-3 adrenergic receptor, promotes thermogenesis in primary human brown-beige adipocytes. We next compare the effects of mirabegron on lipolysis and thermogenesis in those caused by relatively specific human beta-1 and beta-2 receptor agonists, dobutamine and terbutaline, and used fosgonimeton and isoproterenol as our positive controls. In primary brown-beige siRNA control cells, the white bars, we detected an increase in glycerol release in response to the activation of the beta-2 and the beta-3 adrenergic receptor. Strikingly, these responses were blunted after the treatment with the siRNA ADRB3. Suggesting that intact ADRB3 is required for normal signal transduction downstream of all three beta adrenergic receptors as well as with adenylate cyclase. We next determined the contribution of all three beta adrenergic receptors in thermogenesis by treating the siRNA ADRB3 and the control cells with the same beta-1 and beta-2 receptor agonists. As shown by the OCAR tracing on the bottom left, in response to dobutamine in green, terbutaline in magenta, and mirabegron in blue, we detected a significant increase in uncoupled and maximal respiration in the siRNA control cells only. However, the siRNA ADRB3 cells did not respond to the beta-1 and beta-2 agonist treatment. These data emphasize that the activation of all three beta adrenergic receptors is involved in promoting thermogenesis in human brown-beige adipocytes, and that ADRB3 plays a crucial role in preserving an intact and functional downstream beta-adrenergic signaling cascade. We recapitulated some of these key experiments in a separate immortalized brown adipocyte cell line, and you can learn more about them in the manuscript. So to summarize our main finding, in conclusion, we show that the human brown-beige adipocytes do express functional beta-3 adrenergic receptors, And when we knock down these receptors, this lowers cyclic AMP and affects cyclic AMP-mediated downstream signaling and lipolysis. It also lowers mitochondrial content and cellular respiration, as well as UCP1 expression and UCP1-mediated thermogenesis. Our studies also show that the beta-3-adrenergic receptor agonist mirabegron stimulates lipolysis and thermogenesis in brown beige cells, and it acts through the beta-3-adrenergic receptor. And we finally show that ADRB3 is required for functional cyclic AMP-induced and beta-3-adrenergic receptor agonist-stimulated lipolysis and uncoupled respiration. I would like to acknowledge all the people who were involved in the study and our funding sources, and thank you for watching the Author's Take on our study.